Project communication management practice question. Total question 10. Project communication management is composed of PMP lite mark exam 13 and 14. Knowledge area quiz. Question 1. In the project with adaptive life cycle, the overall scope of the project will be decomposed into a set of requirements and work to be performed, sometime referred to as the answer is product backlog. Number 2, communication management plan should include all of the following, except the answer is risk register. Number 3, when one factor used to determine the effort required to produce a unit of work is increased while all other factors remain fixed, a point will eventually be reached at which addition of that one factor start to yield progressively decreased productivity. This is known as the answer is the law of diminishing return. Number 4, which of the following approach deliberately spend less time trying to define and lock project scope early during the project and spend more time establishing the process for requirements, gathering scope definition and refinement? The answer is agile method. Number 5, you are the project manager and are responsible for the development of a mall. As with any construction project, there will be multiple iterations of the blueprint and engineering drawing. Therefore, you have decided to create an online database that can be used to query the document by name, type, date, etc. This is an example of what types of communication tool. The answer is project management information system. Number 6, you are working on a project with all the team members located in geographically different areas and all communication is by email and chat. It is sometimes hard to infer the true meaning of this message because you cannot see facial expression or her tone of voice. This is an example of the answer is noise. Number 7, in complex and high value project, which of the following activities will typically be performed by a business analyst prior to the project initiation? The answer is determine problem, identify business needs, and variable solution. Number 8, your project calls for communication with an extremely large audience. What communication method would be appropriate under such circumstances? The answer is full communication. Number 9, if you are writing a proposal for additional funding, which communication style should you choose? The answer is formal and upward. Number 10, which of the following two project documents are sometimes perceived as contains a certain degree of redundancy? The answer is project charter and project scope statement. PMP Lite Mark Exam 13. Total question 50 for project communication management exam 13. Test question. Question 1. You have completed your estimates for the project and have determined that it will take 10 months to complete. However, your project sponsor insists that it will be completed in 9 months. How you handle this? The answer is inform the sponsor you will have to explore the option before coming in the timeline. Number 2, a project manager prepared a composite resource calendar. Which of the following is unlikely to be part of the resource calendar? The answer is cost of resources. Number 3, you have just become the project manager of the project already in execution during your first week on the job. You receive multiple requests from different stakeholders asking for project report in various formats. This request is overwhelming you. What should you do first? The answer is review the communication management plan. Number four, a project was awarded based on the competitive proposal. Management made a commitment that a few key team members would work on the project. When such assignments happen, they are, the answer is pre-assignment. Number five, you have recently been assigned to a research project. Although there is a limited number of key stakeholders, there is a big number of other stakeholders involved in this project, especially the one who will be using the research outcome. You have some specific question. Which of the following is the best way to quickly obtain response from a big group of stakeholders? The answer is questionnaire. Number six, your project team members have just started to work together and are now adjusting their work habits and behavior to support each other. Which stage of Tuckman ladder has your team just earned? Just you enter, the answer is norming. Number seven, a project manager had scheduled a number of training programs for the team. However, he was aware that a part of planned training and planned training also took place in a number of ways. Which of this is not one of the ways in which unplanned training can take place? The answer is classroom. Number eight, as part of the procurement process, the procuring organization elected to have an estimate of cost prepared by an outside professional estimator. The estimator came up with an estimate of $500,000. However, the cost estimate prepared by prospective seller were the range of $200,000. How can this be best interpreted? The answer is the procurement statement of work was deficient and ambiguous. Number nine, which of the following allows a project management team to communicate all approved and rejected changes to the stakeholder consistently? The answer is configuration management system. Number 10, which of the following are more important input to the managed stakeholder engagement process in relation to the others? The answer is stakeholder engagement plan and communication management plan. Number 11, which of the following is incorrect? The answer is contingency reserve are not parts of the project cost baseline. Number 12, Linda is a first-time project manager and is analyzing the project schedule. She intends to apply resources leveling and she has been the following guidelines on resource leveling. Which of these four statements is incorrect? The answer is resource leveling is applied to a schedule before it has been analyzed and the critical path method. Number 13, the code of ethics and professional conduct has as its foundation four values identified by practitioner from the global project management community. They are, the answer is responsibility, respect, fairness, and honesty. Number 14, prompt lists are usually developed based on historical information and knowledge accumulated from previous similar project. Which of the following statement about risk prompt list is wrong? The answer is the lowest level of the risk breakdown structure RBS cannot be as a risk prompt list. Number 15, Lina is managing the constructions of new office facility for her company. The project is halfway through the execution. The project sponsor has asked Lina to ensure that all the key project stakeholders are still committed to the project. How can Lina assess the stakeholder current engagement level? The answer is by communicating and interacting with the key stakeholder. Number 16, list of identified risk is found in the risk register. However, the overall high-level project risk is first listed in the project charter. The answer is project charter. Number 17, a number of identifying risks occurred early in the project. As a result, most of the project objectives ended up in jeopardy. The project manager decided to present a case to management that the project be closed down. This is an example of risk avoidance. The answer is risk avoidance. 20% of the work was completed in a project. At this stage, the project manager determined that the budget at completed BEC was no longer viable and developed a forecasted estimate at completion EAC. What index can the project manager use to look at the calculated projection of cost performance that must be achieved on the remaining work? The answer is to complete performance index, TCPI. Number 19, a project use rounding of activity cost estimate data to the nearest $100. Use staff hour as the unit of measure for resources and has a variance threshold of 10% deviation from the baseline plan. This approach are typically documented in the cost management plan. So the answer is cost management plan. Number 20, you are 2 days late on reporting the status of the project you are managing. The status report indicates that the project is lagging behind schedule. During the current week, you are confident of making up some of the lost time. How should you report project status? The answer is, you should report project status exactly as it is. You expect to make some of the lost ground, but will truly represent current status. Number 21, you are a business development manager at a mid-size automobile manufacturing company. Recently, you were given a project to assess the feasibility of manufacturing light-duty truck in a Southeast Asian country. To develop a cost estimate, you visit the country with a team of experts to analyze local resources such as power, labor, and real estate. After the visit, you discuss the finding of automobile manufacturing consultant. The consultant note that the local law of the government bureaucracy typically make foreign investors spend more than a year obtaining all necessary permit. To avoid this delay, the consultant advised giving a small amount of the company's stock to the son of the country president. In return, the president's son will personally expedite the issuing of all required permit. What should you do? The answer is determine the legality of the proposed exchange of stock for permit assistance. Number 22, Sally, a project manager who is a PMP, discovered an error in the estimations of the project. A certain cost was double calculated. As a result, the budget, which is already approved, was now an excess by $25,000. She know that publicizing this information may cause her to get the poor performance appraisal. Since her company is meticulous about such matter, what should she do? The answer is, she should bring this in the notice of the appropriate stakeholder, have the necessary step taken to decrease the budget. Number 23, conformance to requirements and fitness for use are key concept in quality management. Which of the following is another name of customer needs? The answer is voice of the customer. Number 24, at the beginning of the project, a project manager realized that the technical expertise of the team was limited, a risk to the project. Midway through the project management decided this was no longer risk and considered it outdated. As part of which process would he do the risk assessment? The answer is monitoring risk. Number 25, you were just hired by the waste management company to develop a solid waste management program in an underdeveloped country. The project will be on the build operate transfer blast basis and will have a 2-year duration. At the close of the project, local authorities will run the program. The World Bank sponsored the project, and the large consortium has received the award. Your company is subcontracted to do this project, along with 2 more contractor companies. After the project scope was finalized, you develop a cost estimate of US$5.5 million. The sponsor review your detailed costing sheet, and it is concerned about the total cost figure. He tells you that the maximum allowable budget he can allocate for this project is $5 million. What should you do? The answer is evaluate way that can result in cost saving and re-estimate the project. Number 26, a certain project was in the collect requirements piece. The product eventual use could not define the requirements. In this scenario, which of the following tool could have helped determine the requirements? The answer is prototype. Number 27, all team members have not yet been hired for a project. However, the project manager went ahead with estimating activity duration, budgeting, and other activities. What would likely happen to the activity duration? The answer is, the activity duration are likely to change. Number 28, the senior analyst on the project came up with activity duration estimates as follow. Activity A, 10 days plus a lag of 2 days. Activity B, 1 week plus a lead of 3 days. The project manager who reviewed this estimate raised from objection to them. What would they most likely be? The answer is activity duration estimate should not be include any lag or information. Number 29, the sponsor of the project created a document that includes the business needs and the cost benefits analysis. What would this document be termed as? The answer is the business case. Number 30, Mark is managing a telecom network deployment project. The buyer of this telecom network is an external entity. Recently, the customer requested that all feature project updated be posted to their information system automatically. In order to implement this, the project team needs to customize their project management information system so it can be integrated with the customer information system. This is a new customer requirement that was not a part of the original project scope. What should the project manager do? The answer is initiate the formal change control process. Number 31, variance analysis refer to cost performance measurement used to determine the magnitude of variation in comparison to the original cost baseline. What is the trend on the percentage range of acceptable variance as the project progresses? The answer is, the percentage range of acceptable variance will tend to decrease project progresses. Number 32, many organizations consider contract administration to be an administrative function separate from the project organization. Who carries out the functions of contract administration in such organization? The answer is the procurement administrator. Number 33, an experienced project manager was assigned a project of a small scope. Which of the following could be true of the project? The answer is defining activities, sequence activities, estimating activity, durations of developing the schedule, could be reviewed as a single process. Number 34, a project was randomly selected for a quality audit and the external auditor found various issues and non-conformance. The project manager lags a compliant with the quality department that this was improper procedure and he should have received notice since an external auditor was involved. What is your view? The answer is the project manager has no case. Quality audit may be random, confirmed by internal or external auditors. Number 35, you are reviewing the response to the AFP issued by your company for the project that will last a year, not exceed $5 million. Three vendors have been shortlisted. The first, Nostil Tech Inc., is relatively new company in this industry. This has assembled a team of industry experts with vast industry experience and qualification. The second company, Syncom Contractor, has been a business for 20 years. You and your company have a long and positive history working with this vendor. The third company is Sononet LLC. It has been a business 14 years and has a computation of extensive expertise and superior delivery, they are also well known for being one of more expensive provider in the market. You have many relationship with the same contractor staff, which you have established during prior procurement contract with this company. As a result, a project manager from same contractor with whom you are friendly both personally and professionally calls you for clarification on a point. The answer is send the clarification to all three vendor. Number 36, during the procurement process, a constructor relationship is established between a buyer and seller. During the contract life cycle, what is the correct sequence in which the following terminology is applied to the seller, vendor, selected source, and bidder? The answer is the seller is viewed first as a bidder, then as a selected source, and the vendor. Number 37, a project manager is analyzing the relationship between the consumptions of project fund and the work being accomplished. For such expenditure, in which project management process would this be done? The answer is control cost. Number 38, one of the stakeholder of a project initiated a change request, which was then documented in the change control system, who would typically be responsible for approving or rejecting the change request? The answer is an authority within the project management team or external organization. Number 39, a critical project rollout was delayed because one of the stakeholders did not receive necessary communication on time. On further analysis, the project manager discovered that the communication was sent to the wrong teams. This could have happened because the answer is the stakeholder communication requirements were not provided analyzed during the planned communication management process. Number 40, while sequencing activities for a project, the project manager team applied certain discretion dependencies. This was based on their knowledge of best practice within the project application area. What is the potential risk involved in using such dependencies? The answer is they can create arbitrary float value and limit later scheduling option. Number 41, activity attributes extend the description of the activity by identifying various components associated with the activity. Typically, how many attributes are associated with each activity? The answer is the number of attributes varies by application area. Number 42, due to the tight project schedule, a project manager did not document lesson learned throughout the project cycle. However, at the end of the project, he finally documented the lesson learned. Your comment on this is, the answer is, this is not okay. Lesson learned must be documented throughout the project as well as the end of the project. Number 43, a project manager is preparing the WBS for a software project. The WBS includes all the project and project work, but exclude the project management work from the following choices. Choose a statement that correctly describes the situation. The answer is, this is incorrect. Include product work, project work, and project management work. Number 44, as part of earned value management, EVM, a project manager is calculating the two complete performance index, TCPI, based on EAC. The data he has is a follow. The budget at completion for the project is 100,000. The earned value of the project is 25,000. The actual cost to date are 40,000, and the estimate of completion is 115,000. What is the TCPI that he will get? The answer is 1. 45. How can change be made to a project management plan once the project manager baseline it? The answer is by generating a change request and having it approved through perform integrated change control process. Number 46. The morale of the team member of the project is very low. The team member feel they were not given opportunities to participate in the organizational team develop activities do ito over allocation to project tasks and so they miss opportunities to develop which of the following is the most likely cause of this situation. The answer is a poorly defined resource calendar. Number 47, given multiple alternatives, the group decision method that allows the largest block in the group to decide even if more than 50% of the member of the group do not support the decision is, the answer is plurality. Number 48, in a multi-piece project, the procurement team decide to close the procurement applicable to a particular piece of the project. What happens to unresolved claim? The answer is unresolved claim may still be subject to litigation after closure. Number 49, during the control scope process, analysis of the scope performance resulted in a change request to the scope baseline. This change request will be processed for review and disposition in the perform integrated change control. So perform integrated change control is the answer. Number 50, the quality cost of the project rose significantly during the course of the project. A post-mortem analysis of the increased cost revealed that this was due to the poorly defined acceptance criteria during which piece should the acceptance criteria has been properly captured. The answer is defined scope process. PM Lite Mock Exam 14 for Project Communication Management. Total question 50. Question 1. You are an electrical engineer with extensive experience in managing transmission project but limited experiences with electronic design project. However, in a strength assignment, you were recently transferred to another department in your company that focused on electronic design. Furthermore, you were asked to lead a highly important project involvement, both transmission and electronic design, in preparations for a meeting with your manager. To discuss this opportunity, you review the initial project design brief. Due to your limited background in electronic design, a number of items in this document seems unclear to you. When you arrive at your meeting, your manager asks if you will be leading the project. How do you respond? The answer is state that you would like to lead the project, but you must disclose your primary domain of expertise is transmission and that you may supplementary training in electronic design. Number 2, a seller begin a prior project that was contacted on the time and materials T&M basis. Based on the agreed upon rates and effort, the initial contract amount was $100,000 over 1 year period. However, when the project was completed, the total contract value turned out to be $350,000 over the 2 year period. What mechanism could you buy have used to prevent this unlimited cost growth and the scheduled change? The answer is use of a not to exceed value and a time limit on the contract. Number 3, the budget is completion BEC for the project is $50,000. The actual cost EC to date are $10,000. The earned value EV is $7,000. At this stage, the project management team did a manual bottom-up simulations of cost and forecast and estimate to complete EPC of $50,000. What is the estimate completion EAC of this project? The answer is $60,000. Number 4, project portfolio and program are different entities in an organization. Which of the following choice states a correct relationship between them? The answer is a portfolio consists of a collection of the project or programs the group together to achieve strategic business objectives. The project program needs not be directly related. Number 5, Quarol is managing a hotel refurbishment project. She has identified her project key stakeholder. Carol now wants to extend this list of stakeholders and convert it to the comprehensive list of the project stakeholders. What should Carol do? The answer is, seek expert judgment from the identified key stakeholder. Number 6, Janice, a project manager, wanted to obtain early feedback on the project requirements. However, she was concerned that the abstract representation of the requirements might not elicit useful feedback. With which of the following tool and technique might help her overcome this hurdle? The answer is prototypes. Number 7, you are the project manager of the project and are about to conduct a risk identification exercise in the few days' time. You want to remind the participants in the exercise beforehand of the various sources of which risk may arise in the project. What could you use to help you do this? The answer is a risk breakdown structure, RBS. Number 8, Ron is a project manager handling an alternative water supply project. During a project performance review, he noticed the following activity. A, on a critical path is delayed by 4 days. B, not on the critical path is delaying by 9 days. Activity C, on the critical path is delaying by 2 days. Activity D, not on the critical path is delayed by 5 days. In what sequence should Ron prioritize his effort in addressing this delay? The answer is first activity A, C, then activity B, and D. Number 9, mini qualities problem plunge a project. The quality of the work product deviated considerably from specifications. The project manager decided to do a root cause analysis. What activities does a root cause analysis include? The answer is a problem identification, discovery of the underlying cause of a pro and development of preventive action. Number 10, Mary has recently finalized her project management plan and has gotten it approved. She is managing a complex manufacturing process improvement project. The project stakeholder constant support and commitment are crucial for the success of the project. Which of the following are the most important stakeholder management process at this stage? The answer is manage stakeholder engagement and monitor stakeholder engagement. Number 11, an important aspect of the project management is the handling of the stakeholder expectation. Typically, at what level are the stakeholders will respect to the project manager? The answer is at all level and with varying degree of authority. Number 12, public recognitions of superior performance creates positive reinforcement for the team member. When is the best time for the project manager to recognize team members' performance? The answer is during the life cycle of the project. Number 13, the requirements elicitation team has generated a large number of ideas during sessions to gather product and project requirements. Which of the following technique is best suited to sorting these ideas into group for review and analysis? The answer is affinity diagram. Number 14, one of the performance requirements of the company website development project is that a homepage should load in 1 second. Such performance requirements are usually part of product requirements. The answer is product requirements. Number 15, Anna has recently taken over the project as the project manager. The project is early on execution piece. Although all the key stakeholders sign off on the project scope statement, Anna leans that some of the key stakeholders do not fully understand the project scope. The stakeholder constant support is crucial for the success of the project. What must Anna do? The answer is conduct one-to-one meeting session with the key stakeholder, ensure they understand the project scope. Number 16, you have just joined a new organization as per project manager. You have heard a number of rumors about the procurement manager having possible underhanded dealing with supplier. However, you have no proof this rumor are true, your project requires a large number of dump truck. Company policy mandate that all purchase go through the procurement department rather than the department employees. The value of the dump truck purchase is $395,000 and the contract went to the supplier or company regularly uses. Shortly after taking delivery of the dump truck, you learn the procurement manager is driving a new car. What should you do? The answer is do nothing. Number 17, the project manager team expect that during the course of the project, there could be delay in component delivery due to a strike, changes to the permitting process, or extensions of a specific engineering duration. What analysis could be helpful in preparing contingency and response plan to mitigate this issue? The answer is what if scenario analysis. Number 18, in the earned value management technique, the cost performance baseline is, the answer is PMB, performance measurement baseline. Number 19, a seller entered into the contract with the buyer. At the end of the project, the seller was reimbursed from the cost of the project but received a low fee based on certain subjective criteria that were specified in the contract. What type of contract is the like? Is this likely to be? The answer is cost plus award fee, CPEF contract. Number 20, you have just completed a solid waste management project in an underdeveloped country. The contractor you are working for has a strict policy of abiding by the local law and rules, although the local resource working on the project have a much more lax approach to following law and policy. Now, at the end of the project, you are handling over the operation requirements to the local operator and disposing of the leftover inventory and other materials that were used during the project. More than 50% of the toxic materials used during the project remains in your inventory. There is no law that would prohibit you from disposing of either the type or quantity of remaining materials in the local sewage system. What should you do? The answer is do not dispose of the materials improperly. Number 21, progressive elaboration is least applicable to which of the following process? The answer is control schedule. Number 22, during a cost performance review with certain senior officer from the finance department, you discover there are certain inconsistencies in the way cost performance reporting is done, and you obtain data that shows this officer are deliberately misleading senior management. What should you do? The answer is bring this to the notice of senior management, even though there's a formal policies in place for whistleblower. Number 23, your company is planning to bid on the project in an application you have never worked before. You are aware your company does not have any resources with the necessary expertise, but you are confident of the ramping up the necessary skills and delivering the project successfully. Further, the buyer has not specifically asked for price experience of the completed project of similar size and scope. Your management is pressuring you to submit a bid. What should you do? The answer is explain the gap of your management clearly and also explain there will be stretch assignment. You can further explain to them that it is to reveal to the potential buyer that your company does not possess necessary skill, but they are too confident of ramping up the necessary skills and delivering the project successfully based on your company track record. Number 24, which of the following process goes beyond the distributions of relevant information and seek to ensure that the information being communicated to the project stakeholder is appropriate, generated, as well as received and understood? The answer is manage communication. Number 25, Eric, a project manager, is a certified PMP. He has responding to an RFP from a buyer and needs to fill a details in his company financial performance. His company has performed poorly during the current quarter, and the result will be published in 2 to 3 days. However, the company has done very well in the previous quarter. The RFP is due to 10 days and all of the information in air RFP is complete except the financial information. What should Eric do? The answer is Eric should wait until the current results are out and update the financial information before sending out the RFP response. Number 26, you are managing the project with more than 130 procurement contractors. Because of the number of contracts, your project team includes a procurement manager and the procurement assistants. Company policy requires that a certain type of procurement be advertised to potential bidder by means of newspaper advertisement. The procurement assistants typically review the bids received and shortlist the supplier for further review by the procurement team. During a meeting to review and select vendor from the shortlisted supplier, you discover that one of the supplier is a company your cousin own. Which of the following is your best course of action? The answer is, ask the procurement manager to lead the vendor selection process for the contract and excuse yourself from the review. Number 27. A buyer and seller are looking to getting into the long-term relationship. Spanning 10 years, both parties would like to be protected from the unstable financial condition of their country, which are beyond their control. What type of contract is appropriate for such relationship? The answer is fixed price with economic price adjustment contract, FPEPA. Number 28, which of the following quality control tools and technique may not be used for root cause analysis? The answer is scatter diagram. Number 29, midway through the collect requirements process, our project manager finds there are many unresolved issues regarding product requirements. Which of the following is usually the best way to discover and resolve issue? The answer is a workshop. Number 30, during the project update meeting, one of the key stakeholders expressed his displeasure over the project management approach. 1% of the product deliverables had minor defect with required a reward. This stakeholder has been resisting stakeholders so far. What must the project manager do to bring the future project performance in line with the approved quality requirements? The answer is investigate the root cause and identify the required corrective action. Number 31, a project manager would like to resolve conflict by a give and take attitude rather than by a one-side approach. Which of this approach is he likely to use? The answer is problem solving. Number 32, a small project with a limited budget is trying to curtail cost. Which of the following process may be eliminated in such a project? The answer is perform quantitative risk analysis. Number 33, a number of deliverables were submitted to the buyer as part of the project. Where would the project manager find documentation on the requirements for formal deliverable acceptance and on how non-conforming deliverables can be addressed? The answer is in the agreement. Number 34, late in the project cycle, it was discovered that some of the project human resource should have trained in the specific methodology. Where should these training strategies have a first been documented? The answer is resource management plan. Number 35, you are managing an electronic chip design project for a customer. There are a number of engineers and subject matter expert from the customer organization that had been assigned as resource to the project, plus several additional design engineer that your company has supplied. All the engineers were involved in the development of the prototype chip an extremely time-consuming and expensive process. Upon the completion of the prototype, you submit it for review to ensure there are no patient infringement issue with the design. However, the review determines there are several issues that could result in an intellectual property dispute with the patent owner should the prototype design be released commercially. Resources from your company develop the affected prototype element as well as from your customer organization. What should you do? The answer is notify the project stakeholder immediately. Number 36, while managing a large project, the project manager decides to include indirect costs as part of his cost estimate. Of indirect costs are included in an estimate. Which of the following is true? The answer is includes indirect costs at the activity level or higher level. Number 37, which of this is not a legitimate model used to analyze stakeholder? The answer is sufficiency model. Number 38, a project manager analyzed the project communication requirements and decided that 10 out of the 30 stakeholder in the project would only need voicemail update of certain information. This type of communication is push communication. Push communication. Number 39, the project involves development. Involves development of high-speed hard disk drive as part of this testing. The hard disk was subjected to continuous operation at the high speed and an elevated temperature. At the end of this test, the hard disk was destroyed beyond use. The cost of this. Such testing is usually classified as appraisal cost. The answer is appraisal cost. Number 40, identification of new risk, reassessment of old risk, and closing of the outdated risk are part of the monitoring risk process. How often should project risk assessment be scheduled? The answer is, it depends on how the project progresses relative to B objectives. Number 41, which of the following is a process of communicating and working with stakeholders to meet their needs and expectation addresses issue as they occur, and further appropriate stakeholder involvement? The answer is manage stakeholder engagement. Number 42, risk has just been assigned as the project manager of a project to develop a complex product. The project is in the defined scope piece. Which of this tool and technique will risk not use in this piece? The answer is process analysis. Number 43, team go through various stages of development according to the Tuckman ladder of development. The stage during which of the least amount of work gets done is usually the forming piece. The answer is the forming piece or forming piece. Number 44, analysis of the scope performance resulted in the change request to the scope baseline. Change request can include all of the following except supportive action. The answer is supportive action. 45, a senior project manager advised a first-time project manager that identifying risk is just one step. On a continuing basis, new risks need to be identified and existing risks need to be analyzed and tracked and their status reported. All this is done as part of what process? The answer is monitor and control project work. Number 46, a project manager has decided to use a decision tree to do a build of the upgrade analysis. The build requires an investment of $200 million on the build decision branch. There is a 60% probability of strong demand yielding a revenue of $400 million and a 40% probability of weak demand yielding a revenue of $150 million. What is the expected monetary value EMV of the build? The answer is $100 million. Number 47, quality metrics used during the control quality process are defined during the process. The answer is plan quality management. Number 48, in order to keep cost low, a project management team decide to apply statistical sampling while inspecting some of the work product. They decide to select 10 out of 50 engineering drawing for inspection. During which process should the sample be collected? The answer is control quality. Number 49, the project manager prepared a presentation that includes data on the project use of resources, improvement in staff efficiency, and the cost saving. These activities are parts of what process? The answer is monitor and control project work. Number 50, a critical resource is on another project team. It is essential that you get his time for your project. You have contacted the resource team manager several times but have received a poor response. What should you consider doing next? The answer is try to use management influence to obtain the resources time. 49, the project manager prepared a presentation that included data on the project use of resources, improvement in staff efficiency, and the cost saving. These activities as part of what process? The answer is monitor and control project work. Number 50, last, the critical resource on the another project team. It is essential that you get his time for your project. You have contacted the resource team manager several times but have received a poor response. What should you consider doing next? The answer is try to use management influence to obtain the resource time. End of project communication management for MAC exam 14.